you to look at this video and listen to how well Representative Ocasio handles herself. She makes some very valid points, and she knows exactly what she's talking about.
Then you get into the partisan issue of money, which is, man, do you want to spend a lot of my tax money on these proposals that you and Bernie and others have? Medicare for all, college tuition, maybe even housing, that the Green New Deal that you have, it is all very expensive, especially on the single payer side, and that it gives people sticker shock.
So first of all, the thing that we need to realize is people talk about the sticker shock of Medicare for all. They do not talk about the sticker shock of our of the cost of our existing system. You know, in a Koch brothers funded study, if any study is going to try to be a little bit slanted, it would be one funded by the Koch brothers. It shows that Medicare for all is actually much more, is actually much cheaper than the current system that we pay right now. And let's not forget that the reason that the Supreme Court upheld the Affordable Care Act is because they ruled that each of these monthly payments that everyday Americans make is a tax. And so while it may not seem like we pay that tax on April 15th, we pay it every single month, or we do pay it tax season if we don't buy, you know, these plans off of the exchange. So we're paying for this system. We Americans have the sticker shock of healthcare as it is. And what we're also not talking about is why aren't we incorporating the cost of all the funeral expenses of those who die because they can't afford access to healthcare? That is part of the cost of our system. Why don't we talk about the cost of reduced productivity because of people who need to go on disability, because of people who are not able to participate in our economy, because they have because they're having issues like diabetes or they don't have access to the healthcare that they need. I think at the end of the day, we see that this is not a pipe dream. Every other developed nation in the world does this. Why can't America? And that is the question that we need to ask. We have done these things before. We write unlimited blank checks for war. We write a we just wrote a $2 trillion check for that tax cut, the GOP tax cut, and nobody asked those folks how are they going to pay for it. So my question is, why is it that our pockets are only empty when it comes to education and healthcare for our kids? Why are pockets only empty when we talk about 100% renewable energy that is going to save this planet and allow our children to thrive? We only have empty pockets when it comes to the morally right things to do. But when it comes to tax cuts for billionaires and when it comes to unlimited war, we seem to be able to invent that that money very easily. And to me, it belies a lack of moral priorities that people have right now, especially the Republican Party.
You just bust their ass out. She said the Republicans ain't got no morals.
We need to spend a lot more time talking about the issues that Americans care about and the issues that are going to get more money in the average American's pocketbook and less money spent on totally expensive health care and education.
Representative Omar is another congresswoman who has been sounding off lately. Here's what she had to say about President Trump.
Quick question. Can you set the record straight when it comes to the Politico interview? I just want to get to your side of the story. Do you believe that Trump and Obama are the same, just different when it comes to their policies? I understand that you refute this Politico story. Could you just set the record straight so we get your side of it? Do you think that President Obama is the same as President
Absolutely
Trump?
Absolutely not. That is silly to even think and equate the two. One is human, the other is...
Is it true that you just think that he's more polished than Trump?
Now you see how white people like to start trouble? Is he more polished? So stay tuned because we got a Somali and a Puerto Rican in Congress and they want to go mano a mano.
Ain't no love in the heart of a city.